Hello and welcome to Basscast number 20. I'm WebEv.
And I am RedX.
Wow, you're close to the microphone. All right, well,
that's what we got to do for the podcast. We got to get up and close with our microphones so we don't have to, you know, lean back in our chairs and.
What are you even?
I have no idea. Sorry.
Talking about.
Let's just jump right into what we're getting into this podcast.
That sounds like a great idea. Let's completely ignore the fact that we've been like in and out and not really recording podcasts for the past like 4, 5, 6 months, and we've now all of a sudden decided that we're going to do our top 20 of 2019 songs. So let's just completely ignore.
Well into the month of the year of 2020.
Yes. Wait, what?
I meant to say, well, into a month in the year of 2020. I said the month instead of a month. I'm sorry.
Let's just jump right into it.
Let's go into this.
Okay, look. Okay, I feel like we owe. Do we owe an apology to our three listeners?
Look, we're sorry. We have personal lives, and we're sorry that we can't do this 24/7 for you. That's all I have to say about that.
I think that it's worth mentioning that, like, we've had, like, a really busy schedule over the past 4 months.
I've been finishing school, and...
Yeah, you've been finishing school, I've been working, and moving, y'all been moving.
Yeah, we've been moving, and... I've been in the process of moving, but we're finally moved in, but...
It's been very busy for both of us, really, and we don't live close to each other, so it's not like we can just, you know, like go over to the other person's house and record. Right. It's like we're recording from two different states, so it's, I know this is terrible, like these are terrible excuses, but...
But it's the truth.
It is the truth, yeah. Let's save that for a later episode, because this episode I just want to concentrate on our top 20, because... We love doing that. I think we love doing it. I love doing this.
I mean, this is our second time doing this, and I mean, who doesn't love talking about their favorite songs of the past year?
But my favorite part is actually ranking them and figuring out, like, collectively our top songs of the year, like, from 20 to 1. And it's always interesting to me because, throughout the year, we talk about this and we kind of have an idea, which songs you're going to like the most, which artists you're going to like the most, and vice versa for me. And to be honest, I get too excited. Like, I just want to, like, whenever I find a new song that I love and that I think is going to make my, you know, top whatever list, I always want to tell you. And then, you know, and then it's like it ruins the surprise at the end of the year, which is a problem. So I need to do a better job of that. But I feel like this list is pretty – I feel like this is a good list.
Yeah, I think it's a great list too. I don't want to spoil anything, but I might have to say that last year's list looks a little bit better than this year's list.
All right. So, yeah, if you like last year's list, then you will definitely hate this year's list.
I did not say that.
Well, I don't know. I mean, I think every list is going to have its, you know, it's going to have its strong points.
Do you want me to go ahead and explain to you why I think, why I said that?
Sure.
Okay. So, don't get me wrong here, okay? A lot of these songs on our top 20 list and some of the songs that we, you know, previously, you know, in order to get this list, how we kind of did this, all of those songs. Those songs are fantastic. In my own opinion, I personally did not think that there were as many good songs this year than there were last year.
Okay. I've kind of thought that a couple of times over the past month or so. I don't think it's that there weren't as many good songs this year as there were last year. I think that the good songs last year were just... Okay, I think that the best songs last year were better than the best songs this year.
And I can agree with you on that, honestly.
I would say it more that way, instead of, like, overall the songs were better last year than this year. I think the strongest songs last year were better than the strongest songs this year. But right. I feel
and,
like...
And that's... And that's kind of like what I'm trying to say. I'm not saying that these songs are like absolutely terrible. I'm saying that these are good songs, but comparing them to last year's songs are pretty much a little bit better than these songs.
Hmm. Well, I don't know. Maybe we can, maybe we should let the listeners decide.
Shall we begin?
Oh, any other? Oh yeah, I did want to say one other thing. Compared to last year, because last year we made it a point to point out, we made it a point to point out that it felt like most of the good songs, like the better songs, came out at the beginning of the year, last year. I think that it was the exact opposite this year. I think that the better songs came out towards the end of the year, at least in my opinion. I don't know if you had that thought.
Let me kind of like think about it.
Yeah, I mean, it's just something that I kind of noticed.
Well, I mean, from the songs that, you know, I picked out from my list, I mean, most of them kind of appeared towards the first half of the year. So I might have to disagree with you
on that. Well, then maybe that was just what I was noticing then. Maybe. I don't know. Or maybe it's just the songs that I picked out, and that's why I was noticing that.
Yeah, because like, you know, cause like I said, from the songs that I that we were comparing that you know I picked out, they were kind of towards the beginning.
Well, shall we just jump right into?
Just jump right into this.
All right, the number 20, the 20th best song, according to WEBev and RedX, collectively,
yes,
is Marshmello and, drumroll please, Savudden Death. Our old friend Savudden Death is back, right? Because we all know that everybody wants to pronounce his name Savudden Death because that sounds better than boring sudden death, right? Yes? Okay. Yes, we're all in agreement of that.
Okay. No.
Yes. tell me. I dare you to tell me. I dare you to sit there.
Do you
want
to be the one outlier when you ever you go see sudden death to be saying, Savudden Death!
No. I dare you to sit there and tell me that when you read Svuddendeath, you do not read it as Savudden Death.
Well,
in like honestly, in your mind.
In my mind, no, because I know that the V is supposed to be a U. He just puts it as a V because that's what DJs do to make their name cooler.
Yes, I get that, but in your mind, you literally look at S V D D E N and you read that sudden. Are you sure?
I mean, now I do.
Wait, now maybe. You say sudden or savudden?
I mean, now I say sudden, but like maybe in the past, I mean, I feel like ever since I've heard of him, I've always thought sudden instead of savudden.
Oh my goodness. I can't. Like for me, it is savudden for the rest of eternity.
You are an English Nazi.
It's better that way, dude.
Okay.
Savudden death.
I'll leave it at that.
Like, okay, sudden death. Everybody has heard of those two words. But savudden? Wait, what? What's that? Savudden? I've never heard that word. Is that even English? It instantly becomes cooler. Okay. I mean, am I right?
Okay.
No. Say yes. Say yes, you are right.
I will accept what you are saying.
No, you're not saying. Say yes.
I will neither confirm nor deny that you are correct.
All right, whatever. Let's get on to this. So, Marshmello and Savudden Death, this is a very out there collab. Like, I never would have thought, like, when 2019 started, I never would have thought Marshmello and Savudden Death. Do you see what you've done to me now? Now I'm starting to think it's Sudden Death instead of Savudden.
That's how it is.
No, it's clearly Savudden.
Okay.
Marshmello and Savudden Death, how in the world did these two get together to create a dubstep song? I don't have an answer. I doubt you have an answer. But however
well,
it happened,
I mean, I think I can understand how this collab came to be.
Tell me.
Well, okay, you know how, you know, Marshmello never shows his face, but we always know that he's .com. So, like, Com apparently is really good friends with Keizo and Yultron and OK. And maybe through that they've done some things. And then maybe because of Behemoth, that's how Sudden Death, you know, he kind of exploded after that. And maybe Marshmallow wanted to do something different.
Yeah, but Sudden Death is hard dubstep, and OK and all those other people are not really hard dubstep.
I don't know. Maybe it's just, you know, I don't know.
Well,
but my guess would be connections. Maybe it just is because of Behemoth and how popular the song got.
Well, I don't know. I wonder if Marshmello sometimes dropped some of the songs in his sets. I've heard some of the songs in a Marshmello set before they did this song. I might just be making that up though. But anyways, all that to say, I love this collab and I love this song. I can't really, like, I don't know, like, for, at least for me, I like Marshmello and I like his music, and I like Sudden Death and I like his dubstep separately. I never would have put these two together, but I think it's a fantastic mix. I don't think you like this song as much as I do, or as much as I did, but I love this song, and I listened to it pretty much throughout the entire year. And this was, again, this was a song that came out towards the beginning of the year. So I had this playing a lot throughout the year. But yeah, this is Marshmello and Sudden Death, and the name of the song is Sell Out.
such sellouts.
You know, sometimes I feel like a sellout. What about you, Alex?
Well, now that I think about it, no.
All right, then. Let's move on to number 19, because Alex doesn't feel like he's a sellout. I was thinking that you might have some kind of deep story, but I guess not. Actually, I don't.
I don't think I've ever been a sellout to anything.
Well, that's very good to know. Very good to know. Very good to hear. It makes me feel reassured that you're being a good brother.
I'm being a good brother. Yeah.
Good. Good deal. All right. That was number 20. So Marshmallows, Flood and Death, number 20. Number 19 is the first remix. We have several remixes. How many? We have five or six or seven remixes on here.
Yeah.
Number 19 is our first remix. It is a dubstep song. And we have to begin by mentioning that Excision put out a remix album of all the songs on Apex. And there are two songs that I want to highlight here. First of all, we've got a Champagne Drip remix of Hoods mm-hmm. Up. When I heard that song, I don't know if you remember how that goes, but when I first heard that song, I was like, holy cow, this Champagne Drip made this? Like, I was used to Champagne, I thought Champagne Drip was into, like, kind of, you know, light, future bass type, you know, type music, but I mean, like, the Champagne Drip remix of Hoods Up, wow, is like a hard, super bassy, hitting bass song, and that's definitely worth a listen, I would say. And I really, really wanted to put it in our top 20 list, but there was one song on the album, on the remix album, that I thought was a little bit better, and it's this one. So this was the Squanto remix of Fight Through the Pain, which is originally by Excision and Sullivan King. And to be completely honest, like, I love it when a dubstep song does not rush too hard. Like, I don't know if this is going to make any sense. It makes sense to me in my mind, but, you know, like, when the second that a dubstep song is about to drop, and sometimes it'll kind of hesitate around a little bit. This song does that very, very well, and the first mm-hmm. drop on the Squanto remix is fantastic. That's coming from a guy who's not a huge Squanto fan. I do like a lot of Squanto music, but, you know, I don't listen to it like, you know, exclusively like I do some other artists. I don't listen to it a lot, but this song, my goodness, I was listening to it a lot this year, and absolutely had to put it in my list. So this is Excision and Sullivan King's Fight Through the Pain, Squanto Remix.
I've got your back. So predictable.
Right, so that was a School and Toe remix of Fight Through the Pain. Again, that first drop, wow, I love it. I just love the way School and Toe put so many different little sounds in there. That's another thing I love about dubstep songs is whenever it's a lot of different sounds right next to each other, and it's like when you're listening to it, your mind kind of has to think. Well, actually, your mind doesn't really think at all. It's just taking everything in. Everything is so different. It's like, you know, you just kind of... It's kind of like the ride of the song is a little bit more better, I guess, if that makes sense.
Yeah, well, more better. I don't think you would say. You just say it would be better.
Oh, okay. Thank you. Thanks, English professor.
You're welcome.
Why don't you go with...
Mr. has to pronounce every single English letter as correctly said in the... dictation of it.
Okay. Well, if you're the English professor, I'm the mathematics professor. 19 minus 1 is...
Don't trip over your own words there, Mr. Professor.
19 minus 1 is 18, so why don't you go with 18, Alex?
Okay. Thank you, Evan. So, as most of you know, and that I've stated on this podcast, and that I follow a lot of the record companies that... Most of these artists release their songs off of. And probably one of my favorites is Never Say Die. So I've been following Never Say Die for the past three years or so, something like that. And one person in particular who has, you know, caught on my radar for, you know, the majority of the time that I've been listening to Never Say Die is a guy by the name of Company. Now, if you know Company, he originally released music off of Firepower Records. And then he, you know, he got bigger and bigger, and now he's releasing off of Never Say Die. And so one of the songs that he's released off of his EPs for this year is a song called Firewall. And Firewall, I'm pretty sure if you've heard of Company before, Firewall is a really, really good song. I have to say that Company is just finding his own unique sound. And I think whenever you hear a Company song, you always recognize it by his sound. And it's like a deep kind of gritty sound. I don't know if you know what I'm talking about. Do you?
When he's doing dubstep?
Yes. That's kind of what he always does. His dubstep. Yes.
Well, this song is kind of trappy, isn't it?
I mean,
It's kind of trap step. He ventures out a little bit in this song.
Yeah, I guess.
But yes, to answer your question, yes, I know what you mean.
Anyway, Company has been, you know, huge on my radar and as of late, and this is probably my favorite song of his from this past year. And this is Company, Firewall. Was Company Firewall. Again, I think that song is probably Company's best song of 2019. I think he made a VIP for it or something like that. And I think that song is also really cool because it's got like in the previous song in Squinto's remix, it was kind of got that delayed drop. You know what I'm talking about?
I think so.
Yeah, I think in it's in the VIP of this song.
Well, I was checking. I was trying to check to see if there was a VIP. I'm not seeing it on Spotify, but maybe it's on SoundCloud.
It's either this song or it's either anyway, I just know that there's a delayed drop in the Firewall song somewhere. Okay. Anyway, let's move on to number 17. Now, number 17 is another one of our remixes. It is by a well-known artist by the name of Panda Eyes. Panda Eyes has been releasing off of Disciple. He did a remix to a Virtual Riot song called In My Head. Now, I usually get most of my music off of SoundCloud, and I was scrolling through my my homepage or my stream page now, and I saw the song. You know, I just go through my normal, I go through a weekly thing of just listening to all the songs that were reposted on my stream, and I heard the song, and I was like, okay, this song is actually really, really good. And it's one of those, it's like a delayed drop, but like the delayed portion is like a future bass sound, but then it drops into something totally completely different, and it's like a dubstep, and you'll hear it, what I'm talking about, if you've never heard this song. But if you know it, if you have heard this song and know the song, then you know what I'm talking about. And it's really, really, really cool.
Yes, this, by the way, this song is not on Spotify, so that makes me think this is not an official remix. I mean, obviously it's a Panda Eyes remix, but I don't think it was like, it might be kind of like a bootleg, if you know what I mean.
Yeah, it might be, but oh man, when I heard the song, it caught my attention at first, and then when I heard it again, it was like, oh wow, this is actually really, I really like how this sounds. And it's like the first, it's, I think I slightly like the second drop better, but I mean, you'll hear the song when it's played. But
quick question. Really, really cool. Quick, yes. Question. For the English professor, the vocals are done by, is this Prism?
I'm assuming that's Prism. Yes.
Okay. PRXZM. I'm assuming that's Prism. I think that's worth mentioning because I actually do like the vocals in this as well.
Oh yeah. And here it is, Virtual Riot In My Head, Panda Eyes remix.
Losing track of time and space, running against my own race, feeling like the walls are caving.
right, our next song is... we've been kind of hovering around the dubstep realm so far in this list. Let's move to some mid-tempo, shall we?
Oh, yes.
Number 16, one of our favorite artists, Rez, has a collab. Well, first of all, Rez came out with an EP called... the EP was called Certain Kind of Magic. How many was there? There's 8 songs on this EP. I think we really liked the EP. Obviously, Rez has a very distinct sound, a very, like, unique mid-tempo sound. And another rising mid-tempo, and he kind of does some, we don't actually know if it's a he or she or it, whatever. The other person I'm talking about is Death Pack. Death Pack does some mid-tempo, some kind of dark house type music. They're both very, like, you know, dark themed music producers. But anyways, Rez and Death Pack had a song on Rez's EP this year called Life and Death. Now, these two have collabed before. Last year they had a song called Life and Death. That was also a great song. But this song is now called Kiss of Death. I think this is kind of quote unquote a sequel to that song. I mean, if you think
sounds about like it could be.
Yeah, I mean, like, if you think about the first one is like Life and Death, and now the second song is Kiss of Death. Life and Death was good. Kiss of Death this year, Kiss of Death 2019, fantastic song. I was listening to this a lot this year, and I definitely had to put it in my list. So this is Rez and Death Pact, Kiss of Death.
Stop.
So I have a prediction, Evan. I think that this year in 2020, Res and Death Pact are going to do another song, and it's going to be called Resurrection.
So they're going to do... Well, are you, like, is this, like, some inside info you know, or...
No, this is my prediction.
Oh, you just have a prediction, okay.
Mm-hmm.
So
we've gone from life or death to kiss of death, and now we're dead, so now we should be resurrected. So I'm thinking it's going to be, like, resurrect or something
like
that.
Like, the first one is your choice, life, death.
Yeah.
The second song is kiss of death, so now we're mm-hmm. dead. The mm-hmm. third song you think is going to be called resurrection?
Or resurrect or something like that, yeah.
Resurrect.
Dealing with coming back from the dead or something.
Dude, like and if they spelled it resurrect,
my goodness. Prediction is much better.
If they do that, you heard it here first. If they don't do that, then ignore this podcast.
And they don't spell it R-E-Z-Z. Oh.
My goodness. I'm trying to think... Like, has Rez been, like, teasing a new release or anything?
Because
Death Pact hasn't really done, like...
I don't know.
Well, Death Pact has done, I think, an EP where it's just by itself. Like, just a few songs, I believe. But the thing about, like, Death Pact on Twitter, we don't know who it is. They haven't really put out much information as far as, like, what it is, like who it is. I don't think I've ever seen a video of Death Pact actually DJing, so it might just be a producer for right now. But yeah, if they did a song and it's called Resurrection, that'd be awesome.
That'd be great.
That would be super tight. All right, that was number 16. Alex, you have number 15.
All right, number 15 is by a guy who I think he's pretty well known. Would you think that he's pretty well known?
Fairly well known, but I just want to say, can I just interrupt? This artist, we love this artist.
Oh,
I
feel this guy is fantastic.
I feel like he's super underrated.
I'll go ahead and say, like, I love dubstep. I love future bass, but, like, this type of sound, it's like a lot new to me, and I really, really love it.
I do too.
I absolutely love it.
I do too, and I don't know how to describe it. Let's go ahead and say his name. I don't think we've said his name.
So this is a guy named Minesweeper. If you've heard of Minesweeper, then you know exactly what we're talking about. If you haven't heard of Minesweeper, then you are in for a treat. The song that we're going to play, well, that I've chosen for our list, it came out, I think, like August or September or something like that last year, and it's called L.A. And so I don't remember how many songs Minesweeper released last year. I want to say it was not that many, but of the songs that he released, my goodness, this song, I think it's one of the coolest sounding songs that he's made of last year. And so this is Minesweeper L.A.
Week living in LA. Swag. Second week living in LA. Bring those feels good.
It's your boy. I mean, it's...
So I would probably say that the best way to describe that genre, that kind of unique trap sound, I'd call it hybrid trap. I think because it's not hard trap. It's not like really chill. It's just kind of like in the middle. Like I think it's great to listen to late at night. For some reason, it's very good late at night music. But I'd call that hybrid trap. I think it's a great sound.
Oh yeah,
and Minesweeper does it very well.
And I kind of want to piggyback his sound on another person who releases off of Never Say Die. You've heard of him. His name is Mor Kismet. Mor Kismet has another kind of really unique sound, and I'm not saying it sounds similar to Minesweeper's, but it's got that same vibe that Minesweeper's sound does have. And I absolutely love those two sounds, and it's just it's a new sound for me, and it just sounds really, really good. Okay. All right. So now that was number 15, number 14 is a song that, I'm sure in his sets. Well, first off, it is a remix. The song I'm pretty sure was starting to be played in his sets. I want to say starting EDC Las Vegas. So you know that this is going to be a big name. The song is by Dylan Francis and Alice in Wonderland. It's called Lost My Mind, and the remix I'm talking about is of course Nightmare's remix. Nightmare, of course, is a big name in the bass community. He's basically been increasing his popularity ever since, 2016, 15, for all I know. I heard this remix kind of close to, I want to say...
This was towards the beginning of the year, I think.
I'm saying he started playing it in his sets close to the beginning, around EDC Las Vegas, but then he never released it until, I don't know, September or something like that, or September or October. And so when I heard it, because I follow him on Instagram and he, played it on his whenever he would post sometimes. And I heard it and I was like, actually, this sounds really good. And so when he finally released it, I got it and I listened to it and it was like, okay, this is actually one of those really cool. This song just has elements to it that I really thoroughly enjoy in an electronic song. There's, of course, it sounds really pretty, but the element that I'm talking about, it's there's a point in the song before the drop where the drums, they hit where you can, if you're counting up to the drop, you go 1, 2, 1, 2, 3. It's the drums, they kind of count along. They beat with your count. And it's just, when I hear that in a song, it just makes me it's oh, that's awesome. in my opinion. And this song does that. And then, like, just along with the drop and along with the lyrics and this is just a really, really good sounding song. And this is why I think it deserves to be on the list. And here it is. Dylan Francis and Alice in Wonderland, Lost My Mind, Nightmare Remix.
That song is a very juicy, like, the names on that song is makes it a juicy song because,
yeah.
I mean, obviously Dylan Francis and Alice in Wonderland are now two of, I mean, Dylan Francis already was, Alice in Wonderland is quickly growing, two of the more popular, bass music artists. Nightmare obviously already was up there as well. So this is a huge remix for an already big collab, and I think it's a good mix. That was number 14. Let's move on to number 13. Now this song, I will not be surprised if a lot of people have not heard of this song, but earlier last year there was a remix by a guy named Plasma. I'm pretty sure it's pronounced Plasma. It's spelled PLSMA, And I would love, like, in my mind, again, this is going back to Savudden. In my mind, when I read this, I read Plisma, but I'm pretty sure it's Plasma.
Or maybe it's Plisma, because you know how most people like
Plisma. I didn't think of that.
Like, say PLS. You know, they abbreviate to PLS.
That's a good point.
But with the MA after there's probably Plasma.
I would guess Plasma. But anyways, Plasma is not a huge artist. I think he's got several thousand followers on SoundCloud. So he is growing. But this song, I just could not stop listening to it. So there's another artist that we actually have talked about and we saw live earlier in 2019 in a B2B. His name is Toukine. So Toukine created a song called Crash. A lot of different artists remixed it. I think More Kismet remixed it.
I think you're right. I want to say that I was looking at this on SoundCloud, and I saw More Kismet remix.
I'm pretty sure More Kismet remixed it, but the remix that I could not stop listening to was by this guy, Plasma. Very interesting little tidbit. So I was listening to the song one day while I was driving to work, and I was like turning right on a red, and like I moved up and then I stopped and the guy behind me hit me. He fender bendered me. So while I'm listening to the song Crash, I actually got in a crash. Now,
really?
Well, okay, that sounds really bad. It was not bad at all. It was like just like a tiny little nick in my license plate. It wasn't bad at all. But I thought that was kind of like, you know, kind of crazy that I was listening to a song called Crash. And technically, kind of got into a crash.
Well, luckily you didn't turn into Plasma. Was the guy Toukine?
Good joke. Wait, what did you say?
I said, was the guy Toukine?
Wow.
Sorry.
And at that, at this, right now, we're just going to play the song. This is Toukine, Crash, Plasma Remix.
Three. chase a ball into the street.
Yeah, I don't know. I love the second drop. There's something great about that. The bass line, the dipping bass line in that second drop that I can't get enough of. Plasma is actually an artist that I've been talking to a little bit on SoundCloud in the DMs, and I'm hoping maybe one day we can have him on for a little interview. Plasma's obviously a whole lot bigger than we are, so he would actually be doing a favor by us having him on our podcast. But I think every individual artist has their own little story, and why not? Let's try to find out more about every artist, and if Plasma's up for it, then I think we can definitely have him on here for an episode.
Mm-hmm. All right, so that was, of course, Too Kind Crash Plasma Remix. All right, that was number 13, so let's move on to number 12. Okay, so number 12 is another big name, in the dubstep bass community. Again, releases primarily on Never Say Die. Like I said, Never Say Die is kind of one of my favorite record labels, and so this song...
Wait, I have a really important question.
Okay, what's your important question? Why you have to interrupt me here in this number 12 song?
Have you ever said die?
All right,
let's continue.
So let's continue. So Never Say Die. This guy mainly releases off of Never Say Die. Probably one of my top three favorite music producers and DJs. I've seen him, I think, once at EDC. Unfortunately, I've only seen him once. I wish I could see him multiple times. The guy who I'm talking about, of course, is the one, the only, Zomboy. Zomboy, I don't know how long I've been listening to him, but he's just been one of my favorite music producers of dubstep. He was actually, because back in the day when I started to listen to EDM, I kind of primarily listened to only Skrillex, and then I listened to Bass Nectar through you because you listened to Bass Nectar. And so I was, back in the day, keep this in mind, as back in the day, I was listening to Pandora. Yes, Pandora, the hideous. Goodness. We've had that conversation
referring
back to that past podcast episode. Enter that podcast episode link here. He was one of the songs that there was one of his songs that was playing when I was listening to one of those radio stations on Pandora. And from there, I went to Spotify and I just searched all Zomboy songs, and Zomboy just exploded on my radar. And so this song, it's called Born to Survive. Born to Survive is, it's a fantastic song. And I'm going to kind of refer back to one of the songs that I was talking about, number 17, the Virtual Riot Panda Eyes remix. It's kind of similar to this song in that it's a delayed drop, and it's kind of got that future bass delayed drop, and then it kind of goes into something heavy. And it's just so, so good.
You know, Alex, sometimes when I listen to this song, I feel like I was born to survive.
Did you have a little Rook's Soul?
Wow, interesting you say that. It looks like Rook's Soul is the feature on this. How do you actually know how to pronounce that?
No idea. I guess it would just be RX Soul. I have no idea.
Okay. Why do we not do why do we not research this stuff before we start recording?
I don't know. Because I think when people go and search, the song, when we give them the artist and we give them the song title, they'll see the featuring on the song title, so they'll be like, oh, okay, so this person did the vocals, now we know.
Well, that's a very good point, and I think sometimes also, we wake up late, when it's time to go to work, we wake up late, and we get an infection, we turn into Zomboys.
And without a doubt, here is Zomboy, Born to Survive.
Never thought I'd have to say this, but if we don't hold out till tomorrow, it's gonna be our faces. they'll remember if it all goes crashing, burning down, crying out till there's nothing left. I forget myself. Until the next sunrise, might make it out of here alive, 'cause you and I were born to survive.
Back, without a doubt, that was Zomboy Born to Survive featuring RX Soul.
Or Rick Soul.
We or Rick no Soul.
I guess it's just RX Soul. Anyway.
RX Soul. That was number 12. Let's move on to the last song for this episode. Number 11. Let's finish this little initial list with a future bass song. Circus Records, correct?
Yes.
Okay. Circus Records has an artist named Cramac. Cramac is not huge, but he's been doing, kind of like music all over, some future bass, some dubstep, some hard bass music.
Mm-hmm.
And Cramac released this song earlier this year called I'd Do It Again, featuring St. Eves. And I was not going to put this song on my top 20 list initially, but I kept listening to it and listening to it towards the end of the year, and it is a fantastic future bass song. It has a new sound. A great thing about future bass is that it's not confined to the same sound. Like, I feel like sometimes house music is confined to the same sounds, just like different tunes. But yeah. Future bass, you can really get creative with the sounds of future bass. And Kramac does a fantastic job of doing a new sounding sound in this song. So this is Kramac again. This is Kramac, and the song's called "I Do It Again." And I'm just saying right now, if I could listen to this song, I would do it again.
Well, don't Kramac your words,
dude. This song is Kramac.
Okay, that was better.
Okay, it's getting bad. Let's just play the song. This is Kramac. I'd Do It Again, featuring St. Eves. Thank you for listening. We will do our top 10 in a week from today.
See you later, guys.
I don't even understand how you left me like you did. Yes, I know I let you in. Should have known you took everything. Never thought I'd break so hard. I'm up here alone, just a falling star. But I'd do it again. I'd do it again. I'd do it again. That's how I knew you were the one for me. I'm falling, I can't stop. Stone walls and the gates lock. Never thought I'd break so hard. I'm up here alone, just a falling star. But I'd do it again.
All right, I will now beatbox sell out. Oh wait, no, that's the wrong song.
You don't even know.
That's the wrong song. It's the. It's the. Hey, Alex, do you ever feel like a sellout?
Well, now that you think about it, no.
Now that I think about it? You mean now that you mentioned it? Okay, are we going to use that or are we going to... Okay, all right.
I don't know. No. Okay, go ahead. I said, was the guy too kind?
Wow.
Sorry.
And at that, at this, right now, we're just going to play the song. This is Too Kind, Crash, Plasma Remix. Wow. Dude, I was literally speechless. Was the guy too kind? Wow. Okay.
Did he not want to crash it so hard, so he was just too kind to nick it in the thing?
And he turned into plasma and it was a remix?
And without a doubt, here is Zomboy, Born to Survive. I don't know why I said it without a doubt.
Without a doubt.
Okay, just leave that. Please leave that.
Yeah, I will.
Because that makes like no sense.
Right, I'm going to come in. I'm going to say, and without a doubt, that was Zomboy.
Okay. Hello, and welcome back to Basscast. This is episode number
20.
So this is part two of our top 20 list of 2019. If you haven't listened to the previous first part for songs 20 through number 11, go ahead and listen to that now before you listen to this one. This is going to be our top 10 songs of 2019. So let's just pick it right back where we left off. So number 10 is a future-based song. Number 10 is a song that I thought was one of the best song, one of the best future-based songs of the year. It's by a group, two guys named Last Heroes. Last Heroes has been releasing off of Ophelia Records, that's Seven Lines' record label. They always release, you know, off of Ophelia. Of course, that's Seven Lines' record label. So there's a lot of future-based artists that release off of there, such as, you know, Jason Ross, and Wooly's been releasing off of there pretty recently.
Yeah, I was gonna. Why is Wooly releasing off of there?
I don't know.
Is there a specific reason?
I'm not entirely too sure about that. I feel like it's just because of the recent.
The collab,
yeah, probably with Excision and Wooly, and then they did a song with Seven Lines, and I don't know, they may have connected and got some deals going on there. I really don't know.
It doesn't seem like Wooly fits the same like niches the rest of the Ophelia artists, but I mean,
you're right.
You know,
you're right.
I'm not here to judge or, you know.
I don't know. I mean, maybe it's just an artist that Seven Lines. It's like maybe like a Excision to Dion Timber kind of thing. Not as necessarily like as close or as collab-y, I guess. But maybe it's something like, hey, I recognize your sound and I actually like your sound enough to put it on my record label.
I gotcha. I'm fine with that.
But yeah, others are, I think, Midas and
Jason Ross.
Yeah, Jason Ross. I think I mentioned him. I can't remember. Trivecta, I think.
Trivecta, yeah. I think you're
and
right.
And there's one other ones, and I can't think of them. But anyway. So Last Heroes. Last Heroes is a guy duo, and they've been creating a bunch of future bass music. The particular song that I'm going to be talking about is the song Awake. Awake is, I don't remember how many songs they released in 2019, but I remember Awake just being One of the best songs that I heard in 2019.
Yeah, Awake is one of the songs. This is from an EP called Moments.
Mm-hmm.
Let's see, how many? 4 songs on that EP.
Yeah, and I just remember this song. It kind of blew me away after I heard it. After a few times, and I said, I knew that it was going to go on my top list of songs for 2019. So here it is, Last Heroes Awake featuring Lauren Martinez.
Coming close into the haze, I'm breathing in and out my lungs. It's on my toes, within my veins, a bitter taste along my tongue.
That was number 10, Last Heroes Awake, featuring Lauren Martinez. I have to say, I like the vocals on that one as well.
Oh, yeah.
Good job by Lauren Martinez. Number 9, that was more of a feature-based song. Number 9, let's move into some hard trap music. I have to say, one of the best artists or artist groups of 2019 has to be ATLians. ATLians dropped an EP, I think kind of like July maybe or August. ATLians dropped an EP called Ghost Planet. This was by far my favorite EP of the entire year. Every song, there's one song at the very beginning that's kind of like an intro song, but every single song on that EP is fantastic, and it is kind of a new sounding song. It's almost to the point where there was three songs on this EP that I wanted to put in my top 20 list, but obviously we're trying to keep it like where we only feature artists once per list or per episode. So limiting that down, I really enjoyed Shelter. Shelter is one of the was one of their main songs that I think they came out with before they dropped the entire EP. The other one worth mentioning before, the one that I liked the most, is called Fading Out, featuring Sarah Skinner. A fantastic future-based song, which is not very ATLians-like, but, again, a hard trap duo group doing future-based always intrigues me, and that song, Fading Out, is fantastic. Now, let's move on to what I think is the best song on the EP. It's called Exterminate, and it's featuring another artist, Heritage. Heritage is not a huge name, but I've noticed Heritage has started doing more and more songs. I'm starting to see Heritage more appearing more on SoundCloud. But this song is such a hard trap song.
It's very hard, very hard.
Super hard song. So I would recommend turning up the volume if you've got some bassy speakers, but the main thing to listen to in this song is that second drop. The first drop is great. The first drop, if I heard it like live, it would definitely make me go crazy, but the second drop is the drop to listen to. So here it is. This is ATLians and Heritage, Exterminate. there's something about the certain bass songs where they play a bass line, but on top of that, it's got that kind of high-pitched ring. And that second,
I know what you're talking about.
Yeah, that second drop in Exterminate has that. And I just love that sound. It's a fantastic sound. And it's even the better your speakers. Like a song like this is where good speakers, good headphones, whatever you're using to listen to music with, that's where good speakers comes into play. Good bassy speakers. Because if you're going to listen to a song like Exterminate, you need good speakers for that, specifically for that second drop, just because it's such a unique bass sound. But I love that song. I love that second drop. That was one of my favorite songs of the year. For us, in our list, it comes in at number 9. Number 8. Let's return back to our favorite song of 2018. Do you remember what it was?
Yes.
1788L. A artist that came out of absolutely nowhere. And I'll tell you, another artist that I have really enjoyed following over the past 2 years now, Ekali. So we've got Ekali and 1788L. They came together and collabed on a song. It's kind of hard to describe the song because it's got two separate drops, which again is something that Alex and I both love. You know, I think it's better to have a song that has two drops and they're two completely different sounding drops. This song has a mid-tempo, a 1788L mid-tempo drop and an Ekali future bass drop. Two completely different sounds. At first, like the first drop, you get the hard mid-tempo 1788L sound. The second drop, you get the nice Ekali, all over the place, harmonic future bass sound. It is a song that is all over the place, but again, that is a good thing, especially in this situation. The song is called Ruin. I believe it came out, it's like it wasn't early 2019, but it was kind of like maybe 3 or 4 months in, if I'm...
Yeah, something around that, I think.
Something like that. Anyways, yeah, the song's called Ruin. You've got a mid-tempo drop. You've got a future bass drop. Ekali, 1788L, doing their thing. Play it. This is Ekali, 1788L, Ruin. if you're trying to find that song, it's worth mentioning the name of the song is Ruin. But since this is 178L and he does things kind of interesting, it's spelled like R space U space I space N. So if you're trying to find that on SoundCloud or Spotify, try searching it like that and you should be able to find it. All right, that was number 8. Number 7 is from an artist that, again, another artist that specifically over the past 2 years, I have just been like, I've been falling as hard as I can because I need to know when this artist is coming out with new music. This next song is Vincent Can't Help Myself featuring Pauline Herr. Now, this song came off of an EP that Vincent released in earlier 2019 called For You. I think the main song on this EP is kind of a small EP with only 5 songs. I think the main song on this EP was Here For You featuring Sad Alex.
Yes.
But, which, by the way, that song is another gorgeous song. And that's a very addicting song. Like, I feel like I could, like, listen to that, you know, a number of times in a row. But my favorite song on here, and I also want to mention, it's got a song called I'm No Magician, featuring Love Alexa, another great song. Breathe 2.0, another great song. Vincent just, I feel like Vincent is a very, very underrated artist. Is Vincent the most underrated artist? No, because I'm pretty sure we'll be talking about who we think is the most underrated artist in a little bit. But I feel like Vincent is one of the most underrated artists. This EP For You is a fantastic and very gorgeous EP. Definitely, definitely worth a listen for any EDM fan. But I say all that to say my favorite song was Can't Help Myself featuring Pauline Herr. An absolutely beautiful future-based song that does not rush itself at all. It takes its time to build up to the drop. There's a point when it starts like the harmonic melody starts pulsating and you think it's about to drop, and it keeps going and keeps going. I love the fact that it does not rush itself. It takes its time, but it's well worth the wait, because the entire song, like the song as a whole, is a fantastic song, very, very beautiful. So, this is Vincent Can't Help Myself featuring Pauline Herr.
Get too close, 'cause I might have to let you go. I saw the waves and now I'm afraid. I'm afraid of losing you, abusing myself when she's choosing you. I can't help myself, I've been craving you.
I can't help myself.
Saw you looking at my phone.
My phone.
So I wanted to let you know.
You know.
You fill in the space. This can't be replaced.
You can't be replaced.
And I'm afraid of losing you. Can't stand by myself when I'm not with you. Can't help myself, I've been craving you. There's no one else. Can't help myself. I can't help myself.
I would absolutely recommend anybody listening to all of those songs on that release that Vincent had this year. But that song was my favorite. Absolutely beautiful song. Beautiful vocals. I feel like the vocalists in these EDM songs, specifically the maybe not specifically, but a lot of times these future based songs have just gorgeous vocals.
Oh yes, they do.
And I know, like, some of it is probably vocal enhancements that the producer is using, but you gotta give it up for some of these vocalists. Like,
oh yeah,
they're not getting most of the most of the love on these songs. I think sometimes, like, the vocals do get some love, but I mean, obviously, with like most songs, the DJ, the producer that creates the music, is getting most of the love. But these vocalists, I mean, there's a lot of talent out there, and I say that to say, like, Pauline Herr, I've definitely seen that name a lot, hovering around specific, like, EDM songs, maybe more specifically future bass. And I feel like you've got other vocalists, like, some names I can just kind of come up off the top of my head. You've got Run, you've got Akyla, you've got Neve, Dylan Matthew, Micah Martin. These are all, these are all vocalists that are doing fantastic work and are extremely, extremely talented. Yet, I feel like most of their work is, with an artist that's maybe getting more of the credit for the song. Now, I mean, I know the artist does the producer does more of the work probably, but, and I'm not trying to say that, like, you know, there's more credit is due somewhere else, but I'm just saying, like, there's a lot of talented vocalists out there that are working with, not just future bass songs, but also with dubstep songs, and with everything under the EDM umbrella. But I just have to say, I love the vocals on this song, it's an absolutely fantastic future bass song. Number six. So this, I don't know if I told you this or not. This is actually my favorite song of the year. This is
really
Evan's personal favorite song of the year. It is a hard trap song. I have one thing to say before I say what the song is. The artist is Tynan, who I don't think we've talked a lot about Tynan on this podcast. Obviously, Tynan is on our radar because he releases a really hard trap, and he does a lot of collabs. Tynan does a lot of collabs.
Yeah, he's been doing a lot of collabs lately.
A ton of collabs, like with a lot of people.
Mm-hmm.
He came out with an EP at the beginning of 2019, and that EP had several good songs on it, but my favorite was the very first one. It's called Between the Devil and the Sea. That's an awesome name. By the way, the name of the EP is called Songs. I think I've mentioned this before. The name of the EP is called Songs for Ghosts to Haunt To, which is like, by itself, that's an awesome name for an EP. That instantly gets me excited. Between the Devil and the Sea was my favorite song. A super, super hard trap song. Now, here's my thing with Tynan. And I don't know if you... I feel like you're not going to feel the same way. But for some reason, Tynan usually either... It's like kind of a hit or miss for me with the Tynan songs, like the new Tynan songs.
Mm-hmm.
But the ones that hit are super, super hard hits for me. For instance, this one. Tynan also did a remix of an ATLian song maybe 1 or 2 years ago. Love that song. Like, it seems like the songs that Tynan does that I love, I really love. The ones that... So, like, and then... It's like also sometimes tying into songs that is kind of, I didn't really do it for me. And everything else is just kind of in the middle. It's not like, at least that's how it is for me. I don't know if you've had similar thoughts or anything like
that.
Well,
I mean, of course I like Tynan. I mean, because I'm pretty sure you're the one that introduced me to him. And then, you know, ever since you introduced me to him, he's taken off in my... you know, liking his music. And so, of course, you know, I guess he doesn't really have a specific sound, but it's more like he just has if he releases a song, it's kind of distinct, not by the sound, but it's like, well, I don't know how to describe.
He's good at that. He's definitely good at releasing distinct sounding songs. Cause he has it's a rough, gruffly bass sound.
Ooh, gruffly. That's a new...
Does that make
sense? It's a new word. Yeah, yeah.
It's like... Of course, I don't know if that... does that make any sense?
Oh, yeah.
Like,
when you said gruffly, I immediately knew what you're talking about.
Are you serious, or are you... I feel like you're... I don't know.
It's like a very deep growl.
It's a growl. It's like a rough growl. It's a gruff. It's a gruff.
It's a gruff. It's a gruff.
It's a rough growl, which makes it a gruff.
A gruff.
See? That's a gruffle.
Gruffle.
Where gruffle is growl, rough, and what? Or growl and ruffle.
What's ruffle?
The chip. Ruffles?
Oh, yeah, okay, yeah.
It's like a growl.
So it's like a crispy sound?
Sure. It's not really crispy, though. It's just...
Is it crunchy?
It's just a very... It's a strong-sounding...
Well, maybe it's a sound between the devil and the sea.
Great segue. And
go.
With that, let's listen. This is Tynan, Between the Devil and the Sea.
Thank you.
Shame on you, Tynan.
What? Why?
No, not you. On Tynan. You know why?
Why?
Not to be I'm going to be another English Nazi here.
Oh, great. Here we
do
go.
Do you know how Tynan used to spell his name?
I think so.
Right now it's T-Y-N-A-N. Do you know how he used to spell it?
Wasn't it N upside down V-N? Or was it regular V?
I think it was a V. T-Y-N-V-N.
Okay.
That was cool. What happened to that?
I don't know. Maybe there's just another brand change that he wanted to do.
Oh, but then
maybe people got too confused or something like that. I don't know.
I feel like that makes it cooler. Plus, it would have given us a chance to call him Tynavin.
Here we go. Tynavin.
Tynavin. All right. Up next, we've got... This is number 5. We've got another future bass. In fact, if I'm not mistaken, I believe the rest of our list, numbers 1 through 5, is future bass. Am I correct?
I don't know if I would say one of these are future bass.
They're all
I would say pretty four future out of bass. The five. I would say 4 out of the 5 are.
They're all pretty future bass, I'd say.
I don't know about number 2.
It's all right, well, we'll get there. We'll get okay. there.
We'll
talk about that when we get there.
Okay.
Number 5. By the way, like this is important. We're getting to our top 5 and they're all possibly future bass. This is very important.
Yeah, this kind of sends a yeah.
So we need to let's focus. So number 5, we got another future bass artist and another up and comer. This artist's name is Nurko. Now, there's not a lot known about Nurko. He's not very new. He's somewhat new to the scene. Nurko has been doing mostly future bass music, and I think mostly singles as well. I don't think he's actually done like an album or an EP. I don't think. I could be wrong on that. I think he's been mostly doing singles, but that being said, most of the singles that he's been coming out with have been fantastic, and one of the songs Nurko did this year is called If It Isn't You, featuring Braden Keller, and I had to put that song on my top 20 list. Now, I did not expect that song to rise up to number 5 for our list. This feels super high for this feels super high for the place that I put it into my initial list. But I know you like. I mean, you ranked this one pretty high, so obviously mm-hmm. you like this one.
Yeah, I thought this was a really good song.
It came out late 2019. This is a very late song. But it is, again, there's nothing really much to say besides the fact that it is gorgeous and it's got fantastic vocals. And it's not, you know, it's another song that the sound is, it's perfect in that it's kind of misplaced a little bit. I don't know if that makes sense. Maybe it'll make more sense after the song is played. But it is another gorgeous future-based song. And let's just play it. This is Nurko, If It Isn't You, featuring Braden Keller.
Why has everything changed that I've known? Familiar songs remind me of my home, and still the thoughts in my head, they all go all to you, all to you. I don't wanna go through. this out on my own. But my heart is still yours to hold. I don't wanna go through this all on my own. It's easy to see all the ways that we've grown. I don't wanna go through the motion. I don't wanna waste another night. Finally face these emotions that all this time I've tried to hide. Know that the reason we're, and we're still in better days. And I know I've made a mistake.
That song is epic. I'd also recommend looking at the album art, beautiful album art, and definitely worth a save for your personal collection.
If you call it the album art, even though it's not an album, is it still the album art?
I think so.
Is it really?
I mean, what would you call
it? You just
want to
call it
art?
Like the cover art or something?
But album art is so, like, normal to say. I don't know. That's a good question. I never thought about that. I just can't imagine saying single art or...
I just say the cover.
The cover art. I guess cover art would work. Well, either way, definitely take a look at the cover art for that single. It kind of... I know this might sound kind of cliche, but it, at least in my opinion, it perfectly visualizes that song. Like, listening to that song, the cover art makes 100% sense.
Mm.
All right, that was number five. Number four, we've got another future-based song. This is from one of my personal favorite future-based artists. It's actually a duo, Klax. Klax came out with a song at the very beginning of the year featuring Basco. It's called Happy. This song is... It's not a very complicated song. It's a pretty simple song, but you've got fantastic vocals, you've got a beautiful drop, two beautiful drops, and this is gonna be cliche Evan talking, but the song actually does make me feel happy. It's a very happy sounding song. You know, a lot of times, I would say sometimes future bass can sound depressing, especially if you got, you know, like artists like Said the Sky that I feel like intentionally makes sad sounding songs. This song though, it's kind of a more cheery theme, I would say. And, it's definitely more of an uplifting song. Klax is known for very fast little waves in their sound. However, this one doesn't really have that normal Klax sound, but I will say the song itself is a beautiful, beautiful song. I think it's worth mentioning that you rated this pretty high. Like, that's how it came in at our number mm-hmm. four. I was also surprised that this also came in at number four, but after we voted, that's where it is, and so that's fine. Klax actually was also on our list last year, and I think they were lower, so Klax has moved up in our top 20 list, and so I think Klax is a fantastic DJ duo that is worth checking out, you know, whether you like future bass or hard music, because they do a little bit of kind of hard bass music as well. So let's go ahead and play it. This is Clax and Basco, Happy.
I've been going out too much, I know. So confused. I know you've been looking for somebody new. Yeah, yeah. Cause I've been waiting so long to tell you how I feel. To tell you how I feel. Yeah. I just want you to be happy. To be happy. I just want you to be happy, to be happy. Sleeping out too much, I know. Coming home late, crashing through my door. I'm sorry that I got this so confused. I don't wanna look for somebody new. No, no. Cause I've been waiting so long to tell you how I feel. Tell you how I feel, yeah. I just want you to be happy, to be happy. I just want you to be happy.
So yes, we are going to be continuing our future bass top five songs. One of them I think is not top five, but we'll get to that.
Whoa. You mean one of them you don't think is future bass?
Well, at least I don't consider it to be future bass. Now other people might consider it to be future bass.
I don't know.
Anyway,
we'll get there.
Let's move on to number three. So number three. So here is our top three songs.
Top three. This is
2019.
Top three songs of 2019. This is important.
This is WebEv and RedX's cream of the crop. Top three songs of 2019. Okay.
So by the way, I'm sorry to interrupt. Can we just give a big shout out to our two listeners? Thank you, yes, both of you.
Thank you for caring or at least listening to what we have to say about bass music. All right, let's get back into this top three. So number three, this guy is, I don't know if I've said this on any of our previous podcasts, but this is the first person who I ever saw live at a rave, at a concert.
Yes, and I was there with you.
Yes, we saw this guy in Orlando Remembering having a super, super fun time. My neck was broken after headbanging all night. But the guy I am talking about, and I'm pretty sure most people should know who I'm talking about. His name is Bear Grylls. Bear Grylls has been one of my favorite artists to listen to. Of course, he was a dubstep producer. He's done a lot of collabs. I believe he released his album last year. So many good songs off that album.
I think it's worth mentioning Bear Grylls is a dubstep artist that now does a lot of different stuff.
Oh yeah, he does a lot of different stuff. And fortunately, a lot of that different stuff is future bass. If you have listened to any of the songs off of that recent album, you'll know that he's done a few future bass songs, and I think the one that really, you know, caught me was the song Demons, and that's featuring, of course, by the great Run. She does the vocals on that song, and my goodness, that song, oh, it is fantastic.
It's now, beautiful.
I also have to mention that later on this past year in 2019, he did another song with Run, who also did the vocals, and that song was called Angels. And I think that's a great kind of sequel to her song, to the song Demons. But, oh my goodness, this Demon song, it just really caught me. And I also kind of want to give Angels, like, the runner-up position to second this, because, like, I really wanted to put both Angels and Demons on my list. But, like, as we kind of want to keep this fair to keep one artist per list.
Yeah, we're trying to keep it limited.
So it's kind of hard for me to make this decision. Yeah. So I had to go with Demons. Demons was kind of my top contender for on my list. So here it is, Bear Grylls, Demons featuring Run. I just think that Bear Grylls is just killing it right now. I mean, he's pretty much exploded. He's been doing a lot of touring. He's made some great music, and he just recently released another Future Bass song. Man, he's just really killing it right now.
Yeah, can we just take a second to appreciate that Bear Grylls used to be like hard dubstep. He was making videos where he was wearing, you know, the full bear suit.
Yeah, the full bear suit. I'm pretty sure, like he said, it had like fungus or mold growing in it while he was actually like,
because he's sweating in it. It's the same suit. Yeah. And he's sweating in it. Mm-hmm. He's making videos with like, you know, girls licking honey off of his bear suit and crazy stuff like that. And then out of nowhere, he started collabing and making these beautiful Future Bass song, and he's killing it every time
he's doing it so yeah, well.
I think they're better than his hard songs. I think they're easily better than his hard songs.
Yeah, I would say that. Yeah, I might possibly say that to some of his harder songs.
Yeah, I think it's no question. I think if you see Bear Grylls coming out with a chill song, click play as fast as possible.
Oh yeah, most definitely. Or like it as fast as possible, or add it to one of your playlists.
Yeah.
So, again, we're moving on to number two. I say that this song is not Future Bass, although it is made by a future bass artist. I wouldn't classify it as Future Bass. I would kind of classify it as hard trap because. Okay, so over the past year, this guy, I'd say he did half of his releases were Future Bass and half of his releases were like hard trap songs. And this song, it just, as soon as both of us heard it, because I want to say that either you told me to listen to this song or I found this song and we both heard it at the same time or something like that. I can't remember. But I'll just go ahead and tell you first off, the person who we are talking about is Kaivon.
Kaivon, oh my goodness.
Now, Kaivon, if you haven't heard of him, if you haven't heard of any of his music, you need to go listen to him
like,
right now.
You need to like turn off this podcast and you listen to Kaivon. I didn't mean to like interrupt you, but like it is criminal how good Kaivon is. And I'm not just making a joke. Like, every single one of his songs...
Yes, every single one of his releases are, like, absolutely fantastic.
And I don't think... Like, and I don't know if anybody that listens to those and doesn't... It's like, eh. I've never seen anybody...
I don't think there is... I don't see how you could. I don't see how you could.
If I show Kaivon songs to my friends, like... Always, I get a good reaction.
Oh yeah,
Kaivon is an artist that I can trust, that I can show, and they'll be like, oh wow, this sounds cool.
Now again, I have to say that we're having to limit only one per customer, and I mean one song per artist. I mean,
no, that's the rule, dude.
Songs. I mean, that's we can't pick all the Kaivon
songs. That's the rule. Otherwise, there would have been like two or three Slander songs, four Kaivon songs on this list,
because. Both you and I had a Kaivon song.
Yes,
this song, it just came barely in front, like 1 point, right?
1 point. This song, this was your submission.
Yeah, this was my Kaivon.
This was your Kaivon submission. My Kaivon submission came 1 point short. Which, can I please mention that it's called "Run the Trap"? That song is
very, very hard. It's another one of Kaivon's hard trap songs that he did this past year, and it is a very good song.
Well, I want to stop you there because I don't think it's really a trap song. It's definitely more of a dubstep sounding song, even though it's called "Run the Trap." I get it, but. It definitely has a dubstep.
Actually, yeah,
beat.
No, you're right. Yeah, it is more of a dubstep. I'm sorry, that's my mistake.
Well, I've always wondered about that, but not important. Go listen to "Run the Trap" right after you listen to this. Which
okay,
yeah.
Although that "Run the Trap" is a very, very hard song, in my personal opinion, I think it wasn't as good as this song. And the song that I am talking about is Kaivon's remix of the Lana Del Rey "Dark Paradise." This song came out, I think, early January, and as soon as I heard this song, I instantly liked it and put it on my list as going to be a top contender for my 2019 list, without a doubt. And honestly, it's probably one of the hardest songs that I heard out of all of 2019, and it is a fantastic song.
It is. It's so hard to describe the sound that Kaivon uses in his drops.
And the thing is,
it's like the most full, like the fullest, deepest bass.
And the thing is with Kaivon songs, because I think we've mentioned this before, is that he kind of, like, on the verses, I guess we call it verses part. I don't know what specifically to call this. Like, the, not the chorus, but, like, you know, the verses part. I don't know what to call this. The build-ups? Not the build-ups, but...
You can call it the verses.
Okay, the verses parts. He quietens them down, okay, to, like, you know,
yes,
to make it, like, super, you know, exciting for the drop and everything. And it, and he does this for this song, and it's so good.
I
absolutely love that.
I don't know if he's specifically doing that. He's definitely doing something from the build-ups to the drops. He's definitely,
I don't know if he, like, turns, sets those verses, like, at the sound quality, I don't know, at like 60% or something like that, and then he turns up for the drops at like 90%, but it's just absolutely fantastic how he does that.
I think there's something about the quality of the sounds he's using in his drops, because they're just so rich sounding. It's the exact same feel that I was getting when I first started listening to, like, 178L, like, yeah, last year. Definitely. It's just like there's a rich feeling to that sound.
Yeah, it's like,
it feels like more, like it's a more, mm-hmm, fuller, richer sound or something. Mm-hmm. I don't know if it's specifically louder, but there's something more about it.
To me, it just sounds louder.
Yeah, I love it.
Okay. Well, if you don't know what we're talking about, you're about to find out. And this is here, Lana Del Rey, Dark Paradise, Kaivon Remix. I just absolutely love that song. All the drops are fantastic. Gotta love the vocals from Lana Del Rey. Very, very well-known artist. This song, I don't think it could have beaten any other Kai Von song, honestly. I mean, although we had other Kai Von songs that we wanted to put on this list, but I think this one was the cream of the Kai Von crop, so to speak. Okay. Here we go. Number one of the 2019 WEBev RedX list of 2019.
Darude Sandstorm.
Can you imagine? Anyway.
Or like a remix of it?
So, yeah, I guess it could be. I don't know. Okay. There are just no words to how long.
Yeah. You got to talk about the wait time for this.
Okay. So, I'll tease the artist. Okay, you probably already know what the song is. Okay, so the artist is Slander. Now, of course, everybody knows. I've said this before. I'm a huge fan of Slander. Probably my top three favorite music producers, artists to see live. Have great shows. Their songs that they've been putting out for the past few years, banger after banger, in my opinion. The first time that I heard this song was their EDC set of 2018. They teased this song, they played the whole entire verse, and they went into the long drop and the long buildup, and then they finally dropped it, and that was it. And I want to say that I was one of the few, because I never didn't see anybody else in the comments saying this until later that year, because I was like, when is this song coming out? When is this song coming out? And so I guess later on, as they kept playing it in their sets, people, you know, kept saying it in their comments, and eventually they finally released it, you know, a month before EDC 2019. And so they said in their song, or in the tweet, Here's a song so that we can all sing it once at EDC 2019, and it was like a month before EDC 2019. And the song, of course, what I'm talking about is Slander, Love Is Gone, featuring Dylan Matthew. Now, of course, Dylan Matthew, the great Dylan Matthew, he's currently right now, it's because we've been, you know, previously we were talking about all these great vocalists. Of course they get, you know, a lot of love for what they do for these songs, but right now, currently, Dylan Matthew is actually touring with Slander right now. And he's doing, you know, a lot of the vocals from the songs that they've created, and I guess other future songs that they have yet to release, unreleased IDs.
Is he singing live, like, how was it?
He's singing on, like, because they have their Slender logo stage, and then he's in front just singing through a microphone.
That's cool. I think that's a nice little touch, because it's like just a little added bonus to the whole experience.
And I kind of want to mention this. So the day that we're recording this is February the 4th, and I think last night I was looking through my Instagram, and they posted another song, which they called it Love Is Gone Part 2, and it's called Walking on Water. There is not an official release date for that song, but I'm honestly ready for that song to be released so I can hear it. And, of course, you know, you can go to their Instagram and listen to it. I'm ready for it to be released and hear how it goes and all that.
The problem with that, though, is that now everybody's going to compare it to this song, which is just so amazingly beautiful. I'm sorry, what was it called?
Walking on Water.
Walking on Water better be... I don't know how it can be better than this.
Well, the thing is that I think Dylan Matthew is a vocalist. I think there's two vocalists. It's a guy and a girl, and the guy is Dylan Matthew. I don't know who the woman is. They might mention it. They might on the post. They might at mention her on the post. I can't remember. But yeah, I'm ready for it to be released so I can hear it. Another song that's going to be out here in a few days. It might be this Friday. I think is Friday. If Friday's the Friday's the 7th. So. just a little, another song that that's on my radar currently with Slander. Of course, you know, the great B2B is Nightmare Slander, because they've been, you know, together ever since they were at Icon. And so they have a song coming out called Feeling Good. And I didn't know, I originally thought this was an original song, but come to find out, I was on YouTube the other day and I see, Michael Bublé singing the same exact song. So it was just a, you know, it's more like a remix song of this song called Feeling Good, but they call it, you know, Feeling G-U-D, based off their record label, Feeling
Good Vibrations.
Good Vibrations, yeah. So that's another song that I'm ready for. I've been waiting for it to come out. So luckily that's coming out Friday.
Real quick, I want to talk about this song, the inside the actual song, because I don't know, like, if you're expecting this to be a hard, typical Slander trap song, you're not going to find it here. This is a feature-based song that it's probably like it takes the most time for it to actually build up and drop. Like, it, like half of the entire song is it building up.
Hey, and the thing is that I think one of the Twitter posts for when they released this song was like, apparently this was like a song 4 years or three, a few years in the making is what they said. So I don't know. If like I really have no idea how long they worked on this project.
Hmm. Well, this one song. That might be including the music video, because
it might be because the music video is, you know, very, very detailed.
The music video is gorgeous.
It is very gorgeous.
It's like cinematically beautiful to look at. It doesn't make a lot of sense. Like I watched it again the other day, like while I was trying to prepare for this for us recording. Because I wanted to like go into the music video, but I don't really understand the meaning of it. I guess that's how a lot of music videos are. It's like you don't really understand what, like maybe you're not really supposed to understand it.
I just watch music videos just to see, I guess, the artist's rendition of what they think their song would be. I guess the message, so to speak.
Yeah, maybe there's not supposed to be a story. Maybe it's just supposed to be just something to look at while you listen to the music. That could be.
Maybe.
But the music video is definitely worth a watch, just because it's so cinematically beautiful.
Mm-hmm.
And when the song finally does drop, the video is crazy. It's a good video. But I think the main note on this song is how it takes its sweet time to build up. Like, it is this, like, Love Is Gone, this song is in no hurry to drop.
No, it's not.
Like, it's like three or four separate build-ups, all for one drop. Only one drop, by the way. Only one drop.
Yeah, one drop. That's it. But it's, like, it's just so epic sounding, though.
It is. This is absolutely an epic song. Very epic. And, again, watching that music video makes it even more epic.
Mm-hmm. Are those all your thoughts on this?
I think so. I think we're ready to introduce. Oh, I'll let you do it. But this is our
number one song of 2019. WEBev RedX's 2019 list. This is Slander, Love Is Gone, featuring Dylan Matthew.
Thank you.
There's something about there. All right, restart.
Take two.
Take two.
Thank you for caring or at least listening to what we have to say about bass music. Okay.
You just said, thank you for caring about what we list about us talking about bass music. I already know what I'm gonna say. Shame on you, Tynan. Oh wait, no, hang on. Let's redo that. Let's redo that. Because I have a
shame on you. Wait. Hold on.
I have to rewrite the script. Hang on a second.
Mm-hmm.
So. I'm gonna say, shame on you, Tynan, and then you just need to be like, what? Why?
Okay.
Shame on you, Tynan.
What? Why?
No, I'm talking to Tynan, not you. Tynan did something. Okay, we got the Grammy. Oh my goodness! Restart. Not the Grammy. The grammar.
All right. Oh.
Were you really about to start? Sorry.
No, I'm kidding. I did that on purpose.
Nuh-uh. Are you joking?
No, yeah, I did that on purpose.
Oh, okay. All right, go ahead.
I feel like you're going to do it again.
Do what?
Okay. All right, so that was Flax. Uh-huh, yeah, that's what I thought.
Uh-huh. All right, I'm sorry. Go ahead. Okay. No, I'm really not.
And here's everyone's going to buzz now. Oh.
What? Okay, all right, look. These are both my hands. All right, there, I have nothing
in my hands. Both my hands? Where you can't see them?
You can't see them.
Okay.